Lou Ferrigno, he's got millions of fans all over the world. He's known as TV's Incredible Hulk. He's two-time Mr. Universe. Close friend of Michael Jackson for many years. In fact, he was working with Michael as a personal trainer. Do you see anything wrong with him?
He was great. You know, later, I don't know where to begin because I was devastated. When I was with Michael, I trained him on and off for 15 years. But when I saw him a few months ago, he looked fantastic. The way he moved, I worked with him different exercises, and I've never seen him look better.
So, are you shocked then?
Devastated. I am extremely devastated. I just wish it was like a dream because we were close friends. We were together with Lou and Michael. It wasn't Michael Jackson, it wasn't Lou Ferrigno. We were friends because he trusted me. And we had the camaraderie because both of us came from difficult childhood. We had the same kind of fathers, so we were very connected.
Was he a good subject? Did he train well?
Yes, he did a lot of core training, stretching, nothing with heavy resistance. And walking on the treadmill, I would use the exercise ball, like band and weight training, because when you're a dancer, it has a lot to do with flexibility, stamina, and you want to be a condition you can be, especially being 51 now.
Did he ever show any chest pains?
No, no.
Ever complain about any health problems?
I was with him, never. As a matter of fact, sometimes he would be dancing, showing the move between sets and exercising, and he convinced me, I said, this guy can pull it off.
Well, how about frail? Wasn't he? He was frail, wasn't he?
When I saw him, he was not frail.
The last time you saw him was when?
It was the end of May. Then I was on a tour doing convention. I was planning to train him a few more sessions before he left for England. But I don't know what happened the last month.
Did he do strenuous exercise?
No, it was all about dancing and flexibility. And you know, Michael, it was so close that it makes me chuckle because we had so much fun together. It wasn't about just training, it was motivation. And when I trained him 15 years ago, compared to now, he hired me back because of the fact that he felt safe with me, he trusted me. Because it's important, because he could not afford to have any kind of injuries.
Do you see any sign of drug use?
No.
But it's pretty clear now that there were drug problems.
Well, I don't know what happened. I don't know anything about your personal life, but the last month, I don't know what happened. But the time I was with him, he seemed fine, alert. No pain at all. As a matter of fact, he's done a lot of the stretching exercise because when you have a lot of pain, you can't stretch that much. So he's very eager to do what I told him.
So this is a total mystery to you?
Yes.
Yeah. Did he ever talk to you about medications he took?
Never. Never. And he was more concerned about his diet, about his health, because he knew that fitness is important, because especially when you get older, you want to maintain what you have. Because after the age of 35, the muscle begins to atrophy, and that's why everyone's on the bandwagon, they want to start exercising.
Have you worked with others, 50 years old, 51?
Everyone, all walks of life. I worked with Mickey Rourke, Chuck Norris, and people like 70, 80 years old. It really doesn't matter as long as you train properly.
All right. Did he belie his years? Was he like younger than 51?
Oh, yeah. He was the same like 20 years ago.
It really was?
Yeah. And it's funny, when we were together, he heard that on Jay Leno that I had a good chance to be on Dancing with the Stars. So he said to me, I want to teach you how to do the moonwalk, because we made a trade-off. Like, he wanted me to get himself in the best physical shape, and he wanted me to teach me about dancing. But the beauty about it, when he moved and all the movement, the guy, I would say, he convinced me that he's going to make the biggest comeback in history.
Really? All right. Yeah. How about his behavior? He was obviously eccentric, a little bizarre, looked a little funny. How did you react to that?
Well, he wasn't like that with me, because when he was with me, the mask came off, the glove came off. It was just me and Michael. We were alone together. And he was just a real, genuine guy. It was no BS, no eccentric. He was brilliant. But we just have fun. He was like, it's just a regular guy like you and I talking.
Did you work out with him at his house?
Yes, the last time. He could not come to my facility because of the fact that people followed him. So I would go to his house.
Did he work with weights?
No, mostly the ball bands, like rubber band, core training, a lot of core training. And walking on the treadmill. He had a treadmill in his house.
He disciplined?
Yes. Yeah, the time he came down, the time I met with him, extremely disciplined.
We'll be back with more. Lou Ferrigno, lots to talk about Michael Jackson. Members of the family were at the BET, the BET Awards, last night. We'll hear from Janet Jackson next. And that was a familiar figure. Lou Ferrigno remains with us. The former Mr. Universe, the former Incredible Hulk. And we're joined now with a return visit with Miko Brando, close friend, longtime employee, was with Michael the night before he passed away, son of the late Marlon Brando. What's the latest you can tell us about the kids?
Kids, as far as I know, are doing fine. They're at their grandparents' house, playing along with their cousins and friends and playing with the animals and just running around the backyard.
How do you think Michael would feel about Catherine getting temporary guardianship?
I think that's all right. I think he would have wanted his mother to do it. She was, yeah, I think that was a good move. The kids obviously know her, feel comfortable. They're at the family house where Michael grew up, so it's a comfort environment.
Lou, did the kids watch him train?
Yeah, as a matter of fact, he brought the kids downstairs. He goes, look who's here, the Incredible Hulk. So he had me flexing my arm, and the kids were so excited. He explained to the kids, this is the original Hulk.
You had a tough father, too, right, as
yes.
He did, so you shared a lot of that in common.
Yes, because Michael's escape was music. My escape was bodybuilding to become a world champion. We shared that together. And it's funny how we both became extremists.
How? How were you an extremist?
Became a bodybuilding champion, obsessed with fitness.
Obsessed.
Fitness, building his body, and being very successful in life. And Michael's the same way with his music because it was his escape.
Miko, you were there at Michael's last rehearsal, this last Wednesday night. Tell us about it. How'd it go?
It went fine. I mean, we started, when he was, I think he had a few meetings before. He got his makeup on, his wardrobe on, went up on stage, danced with the dancers. He did some songs. He did his routine. He gave the crew some technical advice here and there. He went through the routine. Kenny Ortega was there, by him, helping him. He was just another ordinary.
No sign of any physical problem.
No sign. He never said, let's stop. I don't feel well. I need some drink. Or Kevin Bubba. He never complained. Never said, can we take a 5-minute break and let's chill? No.
What was your role?
My role, just for him, but just to be there for him, keep an eye out for him, be there if he needed anything, and help.
You were like his guy.
His guy. He said, "You keep an eye out for me."
Do you know Dr. Murray?
Heard of him. I've never met him. He was never at the forum when we had rehearsals for a few weeks, nor was he at Staples Center.
Did you know him, Lou?
No.
Did he ever talk about his doctor?
No. The thing about Michael was that he was a personal guy. And all he cared about was just being a close friend, just enjoying life. I mean, I don't care what the media said because everybody wants to focus on sometimes the negativity. I judge people for who they are. And there's some people I don't like. I just disassociated with them. But Michael was just very genuine. He loved all people.
Are you angry, Miko, that they look at bad parts of Michael?
I'm angry, especially now because he's not here to defend himself. He was such a good person, a loving person. Every time, anyone who knew him or had any kind of relationship or whatever, you knew he always ended your conversation or your meeting with, "I love you, see you." It was always love. It was always.
Did you ever think he did wrongful things with young boys?
Absolutely not.
Absolutely not. Lou, did you ever think?
First of all, my daughter's godfather. I mean, I'm close to the kids. He spent the night at my house. I'd spent tons of nights at Neverland with my kids and my friends. Absolutely not.
Did you ever suspect anything at all, Lou?
No, because we were just talking, Miko and I, when I went to see him in the Neverland Ranch. He said, "Jump in the car." So he's driving me around. It was just a regular guy.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
It was
Michael.
It was Michael.
But you and I see a side of him that most people don't
see. No, and never will. And never will.
Never will now.
And he never forgot. He never forgot friendship. And especially if he liked you.
It was very
important
to
support you.
Thanks, Lou.
Thank you for having me on your show.
Miko will remain. And Miko, by the way.